Alright, we're gonna start with our floor drills. Going with number one. We're gonna step up and do a front kick. Step back, knee strike. And again, front kick, step back, knee strike. For number two, we have round kick, jab, punch, punch, and switch. So we'll do a front leg, round kick, jab, punch, punch. Then we're gonna switch. And then do that again. For number three, we have double jab, double punch, double knee strikes. And we'll do that 8 times. So we'll do double jab, double punch, double knee. And again, double jab, double punch, double knee. For drill number four, we're gonna do 8 floor jacks and 2 push-ups. And then you'll repeat that at least 4 times. Number five, we have jab cross times 2 and 2 uppercuts. So we're gonna do jab, cross, upper, upper, and switch. And then do that again. For number six, we have double hook, high and double hook low. So it's gonna be the same hand. So we're one arm. So from here, we're gonna go high, then we're gonna go bend our knees, low. High, low. And then we'll do that 8 times, then switch legs and use the arm. Number seven, we're gonna do 10 tricep push-ups. So, which I call these the fully arm push-ups. So let me demonstrate them real quick because you've never done them before. They're easier on the knees, especially for women. So from here, they're gonna come down, they're just gonna fold their arms like a folding chair. And then push up. For the back drills, we're going to do work on stamina and conditioning. So they're going to do each of these drills 1 time, run down the length of your workout floor, and then come back, and then they'll do the second drill. So for the first one, it's 20 alternating punches. They're just going to hit hard, too. Number two, they're going to do 10 alternating front kicks, turn and run. Number three is 10 alternating low hammer fist, and then back fist. So that's not like this. We're gonna do low hammer fist, back fist, and then turn low hammer fist. Okay, they'll do that 10 times, run on the floor. And number four, we have 10 alternating round kicks, or for your advanced students, make them do double kicks, double round kicks before they switch legs. Number five, we have 10 alternating jabs, a double punch, jab, round kick combination. That was kind of tricky, so let me go through it with you. They're gonna do a jab, double punch, jab, and then they're going to wrap your back leg. So it's jab, punch, punch, jab, and then round kick. For partner drills, we're going to do down the floor, so, and then they'll switch partners in between. The first one is double back fist, and they're going to step up, and then the other side double back fist. So we'll go this side first, back fist, step, other leg, double back fist, back fist, okay? So that'll be all the way down the floor. Number two, we're gonna do double jab, double punch, step forward, and then they'll switch legs. So double jab, double punch, step, double jab, double punch. For number three, we have alternating front kicks. That's pretty simple. He's gonna just do front kick, land. And for your advanced students, you might have them even go a little higher on those. For number four, we're gonna step up single or double round kicks. So for your basic students, he's gonna step up round kick one. And then if you have advanced students, work on those doubles. He's gonna step up double round kick. 1, 2, okay? And number five, if you haven't taught hook kicks, go through the basics of a hook kick with your students. We're gonna do a step up hook kick this time. So step up, hook kick. And even throw it in here, you can make it more advanced for your advanced students. Hook kick, round kick. Step up, hook kick, round kick, okay? And then I'll finish with 20 past the target partner sit-ups. So let me show you this one real quick. They're gonna lock their feet together. This bag is going to go over the head, touch the ground, and then they're gonna pass it in between. So everyone's doing a sit-up. So he does a sit-up, and it touches the ground. We do sit-ups, and we pass, okay? And then we'll do that 20 times. For the self-defense, we have the cycles on the ground, so check out those. If you don't know what program that looked like, look at our first planner for the week. It's all described in there. Now for the cool-down. We're working on balance and strength. We're going to do some leg raises without touching the floor. So for the front leg raise, heel in front. So that's the stopping point, not behind. We're going to go right here, so don't throw off yourself a balance. We're going to go up and down, so keeping that heel in front. Do 10 on each leg. Then we're going to do the sideways one. So now what we're going to do is we are going to cross over our foot here. And we're going to pull out, and we're going to bring all the way across our body. So it's over on this side. 10 of those. And then we have from behind. Okay, they're just gonna turn their foot this way again, and we're gonna lift it up and work the glutes and swing it up, straight back like that. So that foot will come in front. So the first one won't have a forward or behind swing. Then we'll go to the ground, do Supermans. So we're gonna hold it for 10 seconds, 5 second rest, hold it for 20, 5 second rest, hold it for 30, and a 5 second rest. Finish up with fire hydrants. We have side kick style, and then we have round kick style. So let me lead you through those really quickly here. So for side kick, their knee comes up and out and in. And then for round kick, it's gonna come up, it's gonna go out this way and back in. All right, and after that, you are finished.